We're back with Edda Mellas and Curt Knox, the parents of Amanda Knox. Here's another excerpt from her comments during the closing arguments of her murder trial. Watch.
Tanti mi dicono che se io fosse loro in quella situazione.
Many people tell me that if they were in my shoes, they would have pulled their hair out by now,
strappati I loro capelli,
tearing their cell apart.
Giù, avrebbero preso la cella a pezzi e.
And I say that I do not do these things. I don't let myself be beaten down. In these situations, I take a deep breath. I try to look for the positive. I try to find the positive in important moments. And I know that this moment is one of those moments. Because in this moment, unlike the previous moments, a true decision must be taken on an action. I feel more in contact with you, more vulnerable in front of you. But I am trusting and confident of my knowledge. And for this, I thank you.
Curt, one of our legals, Lisa Bloom, says the appeal system in Italy is actually fairer for the defendant than in the United States. You don't just have to rule on constitutional grounds. They consider the whole matter. And if they deem someone didn't do it, even if the jury said they did and there was no malfeasance of justice, they could throw the case out. Have you heard the same thing?
Yeah, that's absolutely true. We've also heard that there's a slightly different phase where they could actually open it up for further evaluation of evidence that can even provide new information to the hearing as a whole. So there's very different scenarios than what happens in the United States.
Edda, does that encourage you?
Oh, absolutely. You know, there's many Italians who have told us that, you know, worst case scenario, the first level rarely works correctly, but they'll get it right in appeal. She will get out of there. They will not, you know, put away this innocent young girl for a crime that she didn't commit.
It could take up to a year before it's even heard, right, Curt? Is that going to be hard to deal with?
Well, absolutely. I mean, that would now make 3 years that Amanda has spent in a maximum security prison for something that she had no part of. And, you know, it's frustrating all around. And what really bothers me is it's such a big mistake that took place inside this particular court. And I actually hope they push it up, recognizing that that it was such a failure in this case.
Her attorney said she seemed depressed, Edda. Did you find her that way?
Yeah, you know, she was very, very strong at the beginning, but the last few months have just been devastating for her. She couldn't stay strong forever, and you could really tell that she was suffering. I mean, it was just horrible for her. Today was better. She's ready to fight on. Her lawyers have told her to have courage. She knows that she's getting support from all over the world, which is just amazing, and that helps.
Curt, you said you're going home, what, the next day or so? Are you going to be able to be in touch by phone?
You know, we actually are able to have a 10-minute phone call each week, and that's one of the extremely nice things, to at least be able to hear her voice. And then, you know, Edda will be staying during the rest of the month of December, and then I'll come back in January. So we'll just kind of keep having a person over here at all times like we have for the last 2 years.
So there'll always Edda be someone there. What about letters? Can you mail every day something?
Yeah, oh, absolutely. And she does get a lot of mail, and she loves the mail that she gets. You know, I think she told me she got one letter that was addressed to her that all it said on the envelope was Amanda Knox, Italy, and it got to her, which is just amazing. Yes, she gets lots of letters of support.
Frankly, Curt, are you surprised by all the attention from people and the media?
Well, you know, there's two different perspectives on that, Larry. The first one is the impact that it had on the actual case itself, which really started with a case closed by the prosecution, you know, literally just days after Meredith's death without looking at physical evidence, and the whole snowballing effect that that had of, you know, continuous mistakes being made, and the impact that I personally believe it had on the verdict in this scenario. The other side of the coin is, as Edda said, the amount of support that has come out on her behalf and on our family's behalf has been extraordinary, and we're very thankful for it.
And we'll be back with Edda Mellas and Curt Knox right after this.
Doing for what they are doing. The important thing now is that I thank you, because now it is your turn, and therefore I thank you.
Edda, how has all this changed your daughter?
Oh, you know, none of us will be the same, and Amanda most of all. She went to Italy, this carefree, trusting, naive, just wanting to see the world happy young woman. And she's really become, she had to grow up. She's much more serious. She's much more cautious. It's been hard.
Curt, naturally you weren't there. Is there ever a moment when you have doubt about her innocence?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. It's never even crossed my mind. I mean, the way that she was raised, the way that she goes about her life, the way that she makes her friends, and truly the friends that she has are close friends. They are not kind of just superficial friends. And nothing in her background would ever lead you to believe that she would be associated to something like this.
Edda, in the immediate aftermath of the murder, your family in Germany suggested that Amanda come and stay with them. She didn't. Do you think that would have changed things?
Oh, you know, I kick myself every day that I didn't make her leave the country. And so does my cousin in Germany, because had she left, and none of this would have happened. She wouldn't be where she's at. But, you know, we can't go back and fix that. We just need to go forward.
You don't think they would have extradited?
No, there's no evidence against her. You know, none of that interrogation that they bullied her into, that the Supreme Court found illegal, none of that would have happened. There's no physical evidence of her at the crime scene. They would have had no reason to you know, extradite her or even attempt to arrest her. And they even admit to the fact that they really have no physical evidence, that it's just sort of some bizarre circumstantial stuff that they have.
When we take a break, come right back and ask the parents why they think she was found guilty. Don't go away.